Hi, everybody. My name is Deepali Kumar, and I'm a transplant infectious disease physician in the UHN Transplant Centre. In our last video, I talked about making an informed decision to get COVID vaccine. In this video, I wanted to update you on what you need to know if you've already decided to get the vaccine. Question one, will transplant recipients get priority for the vaccine? As you know, the Ministry of Health has prioritized healthcare workers, long-term care workers, and residents, as well as Indigenous persons, to receive vaccination in phase one. This is because these groups are at the highest risk of contracting COVID. We know that some transplant recipients fall into these groups and have already been vaccinated. Phase two of the Ministry of Health plan says that people with chronic conditions will receive vaccine. We believe this is where most transplant recipients will be included. We are working with the Ministry of Health to ensure that organ transplant recipients are prioritized within phase two. Question two, where can I get the vaccine? At this time, vaccinations are being done at specific vaccine centers. These centers are affiliated with designated hospitals. This is because vaccines we have now, like the Pfizer, BioNTech, and Moderna vaccines, have special storage conditions. And some of the other vaccines that Health Canada is looking at don't have these special storage conditions and could be stored just like other regular vaccines. In this case, there might be an expansion of where the vaccine could be given, for example, at hospital clinics, doctor's offices, or even pharmacies. Things are evolving rapidly in this space, and it will really depend on how many doses of each vaccine we're able to get into the province. Question three, is one vaccine better than another for transplant recipients? As you know, there are a number of vaccines being studied. Believe it or not, there are more than 60 vaccines around the world that are in advanced stages of trials. The Pfizer vaccine, as you know, is 95% effective. Moderna is 94% effective. The Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine is anywhere from 62 to 90% effective. And the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is 85% effective at preventing COVID, and it's one dose. In fact, trials with these vaccines have been done in thousands of people, but none of these vaccines has information on how well they work in transplant recipients. At this time, the most important thing is to get the first COVID vaccine that is available to you. It would not make sense to wait to see which vaccine comes next because you might contract COVID while waiting. So the bottom line is to take what's behind door number one and not wait for door number two. Next question, is there a way to ensure the vaccine works to protect you? There are a few rules to follow with regards to the timing of when you get the vaccine. This is to make sure the vaccine works as best as it can. First, if you can get your vaccine before you're transplanted, that would be the best. But don't put your transplant on hold just to get the vaccine. Waiting times are long and organs are hard to come by. If you've already had your transplant, wait for at least 1 month after your transplant to get vaccinated. This gives time for any high doses of immune suppression you got to wear off. If you were just treated for rejection with high doses of immune suppression, wait for about a month for the same reason, to give time for the high doses of immune suppression to wear off. Next question, what do I need to know about the side effects? The first thing that will happen after your vaccination is that you will be asked to wait for 15 minutes to make sure you don't have any immediate side effects. Local side effects from any of these vaccines are common, especially pain and tenderness at where the injection was given. Some people will have side effects like fever, chills, muscle aches, headaches, or tiredness. This should go away in 1 or 2 days. If it's not going away, then call your coordinator so we can make sure it's not something else. Now, how can I help figure out how well the vaccine works in transplant recipients? There are research studies going on at UHN to see how well the immune system responds to vaccine and if you make protective antibodies. You could help advance that knowledge. If you're interested in learning more, email preventcovid@uhn.ca. Thanks for listening.